Alrighty, what's going on? What's going on, everybody? Alright, let's see what we can do here. Give me just a sec, team. Get this thing cranking. Yeah. Body first. Everybody, sorry I'm slow at getting started here. I had to find my chuck key, it was hiding. Excuse my fat hand. How are we doing this lovely evening? Alright. Let's get cranking, shall we? Charlie's in the house. What's up, Steve? How's everybody doing tonight? Somewhere in Texas. All right. What's up, John? Becky's in the house. What's up, Becky? John Walsh is in the house. What's up, John? How you doing, buddy? Strolling along. Freezing rain sucks. Just got my kid to sleep, man. So, pretty good. Hey, Becky. Yeah, John, this is how I celebrate. Woo! Cooked the wife and the baby a nice steak dinner with cheesecake. And kicked him to the curb. I know, right? The wife's taking a bath. She's happy. Nobody's bugging her. The baby's asleep. And she finally gets to enjoy a nice, cool bath without anybody bothering her. And I'm out here doing this. Thank you. What's up, Vince? Welcome back, buddy. We're here again, doing it again, man. All right, now that there's 25 or 30 of us in here, did y'all see the video I just posted a second ago of my vacuum system over here blowing up? Because it sucked. Good choice, good choice. Charlie is your friend. What's up, Brandon? What's up, Butterbean? that's a Cholla Hybrid. Sweet. Ah, Mark's here. I know Mark saw it. I've yet to have any trouble with it. So now that I've said that, it's gonna blow up. Cholla Hybrid, Butterbean. Butterbean, do you go by Butterbean or Eric? No, I don't mark the centers. Not what I'm doing on the lathe. I kind of let it find its own center before I lock the lathe down. It goes by beam. All right. The cactus police. It's made of apparently Cholla cactus and resin. I'm still gonna call it Cholla. Matthew, yeah, I put the bunk beds together for my daughter the other day, and I wanted to make a video. I made a little time lapse of building it, and then her cute little reaction when I put it together, or when I showed it to her. That is indeed the newest video on the YouTube. There you go, John. No explodees on the brad point drill bit. It's alive still. And not even any chippy outs on the end. Still pretty straight and true on both ends. So, hooray! Brad point to the rescue. So here we go. This is what we're cutting today. This way. Thanks, John. It's a lot easier drilling this stuff than it is drilling steel, which is what I do all day at work. So. One second. Let's put these little babies together, shall we? Yeah, no cooling liquid at all. Cooling liquid on the steel is your friend for sure. Pretty fair sizing on the drill size too. It turned out really nice. Very pleased, very pleased. Go. All right, standard procedure here. One thing I always try and do is where I cut my blank, I'll denote what's the cap and what's the body and make a line where they line up just for reference. And then when I glue it in, I always glue the tube in from the ends that meet each other, because usually that'll get you the closest, you know, of your blank looking as lined up as it can, because you're going to trim off to that side. Matthew, this is going to be an all-gold Kojent rollerball. What's up, Christopher? Alright, and as per usual, come in, backfill on both sides of the barrel with your CA. Keep it from wanting to bust out on you as you go around. Good. Hit that with some accelerator. Go back. Do the front side as well. So you leave no room for explosions later. There we go. Alright, we're good on that side. Ahead again, we're going to glue from the dashed side. Same as before. Do his several rotations so you get that glue nicely distributed around. Same thing. I'm gonna go ahead and backfill around. roll it around, make sure it gets all the way down inside as far as it'll go around. Hit it with the accelerator one more time. Again, do both sides that way. And you're out the dough. Yeehaw! Just a second here. I went and got a new box of the yes, there is some CA there. We will remove it. I need a whole day for that, Ethan. I will get it done very soon. I'll try and make a day next week where I do that one. We'll make a party out of it.
Yep. We're not in use. Reference mark. Body to be turned as the tip.
I mark them to where they just match up to each other. So that's both towards the inside. And yeah, I lock them in to where when you screw it together, it winds up here. And then I'll go back in, now that I've glued them in, and once I get them all barrel trimmed and everything, and I'll mark the inside of the barrel so I can find out my orientation again later, after it's turned. Because it doesn't help if you don't have it on there at the end as well. Let's see what's what here. Batteries dead. Hold up. Alrighty. So lately, I've just been hand doing these a lot. Try to stop every couple seconds so I don't heat it up too much. You're back, you think? You still in the canyon? There we go. So now we're cleaned up on that end. Clean up on this end real quick. Texas has a pretty good amount of that, don't they? Here we go. That side's good to go. This side's good to go. In just a moment, I'll switch out to the 10.5 diameter barrel trimmer. Yeah, I prefer the disc sander method. I just hadn't hooked it all up yet. Very much prefer the disc sander method. It's way better. Way better. But this is all I got right now. BFE New Mexico. Nice. Ah, the old readers. Can't cook them cold. Go. Give that the good enough go ahead and switch over to the second side. Oh, the old ducking autocorrect. What's up, Neil? Good old Jameson and dinner. Yeah. Hang on a second, team. What's up, Rick? Like a glove. Now then, on to the next thing. A dab of oil. I don't know, Neil. Yeah, I tried to tell you anyway. How you doing, Kathy? Just lay down the old cutting edge. Give it a little once over. See if we can't make it cut a little smoother for us. Not like that, you won't. Alrighty. Hey, Ken, how you doing, buddy? Alrighty. Clean this up. Never put your flat sides down. Only do these edges here. If you put the flat side down, it will no longer be a flat surface when you cut, and you'll be in trouble. We don't want to do that. Okay. Throw this back on here. See if that doesn't sharpen us up a little ways. So maybe we can cut this hard child a little bit more. Hey, Johnny, how you doing, buddy? Now, this stuff's really hard. It might be that I just need to put it in the drill press, but at least now it's sharp, hopefully, a little bit better. Much better. Much, much more better. Gotta love it when doing stuff works. Okay, we still got a little ways to go, maybe 1/8 inch. Angry stuff. Angry, angry stuff. Just about there, though. How'd it go, Johnny? She's doing good, man. She's chilling. Kind of getting to relax a little bit. And I'm out here also relaxing a little bit. Not usually, Bean. I usually get mine from all the blank makers in here. Shirley, you mean to tell me that you don't drive that truck to Hawaii?
Can't believe it.
Hey, Neil, got a new toy.
Hey, how about that?
graduated from scissors. Harbor Freight, $3.99, and it comes with three different size heads on it. Very cool little tool. Alright. So that's the new tool toy. Let's get this bushing set up and get ready to rock here. Yeehaw! Alright. Oh yeah. It's definitely a lot of having the right blank making. I don't have the energy or time to do blank making and pin making, so I leave the blank making to the experts like Neil here. Yeah, it's dirt cheap. I mean, it's $3.99 and it just squares all that away for you real fast, real simple, and real accurate. Now I'm into all those three things at $3.99 price. That's $3.99, by the way. Appreciate it, Dave. Very wise, sir. Thanks, Dave. Saving lives over here. Sounds good, Neil. Okie pokies. One more second. That is accurate. I cannot wait to put on my sandals again. But I tell you what though, these New Balance sure are comfortable. Oh man, if you don't have New Balance shoes and you're working on concrete or something, you are missing out hard. Not bad, not bad. How you doing, Nathan? Here we go. Alright, gotta get loud again. Hopefully this stupid thing won't explode on me again. It's the right pair of shoes if you do any kind of standing up for a long period of time. Oh man, they're great. Alright. Let's party. Woo! We made it. We did it. We did it. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. You're doing it right, Matthew. All right then, ready to rock. Let's see what's what. Yeah, rock quartz are nice too. Hey Jeff, no, I'm not 100% sure how it stays so clear. I mean, this is my cell phone that you're on. It's doing the videoing, and I'm watching the video on the cell phone, and the cell phone camera and microphone is right next to my mouth. So, I'm talking almost, like I'm maybe 3 inches from the microphone on the cell phone. So I'd say that's probably why it's nice and clear. Cause the way these things are, the compression is done on these things, it's kind of loud in here with the vacuum system and the lathe, but the compression system on this mic on these cameras is pretty dang good. Yep, I got it on a 4 foot tripod with a 2 foot piece of wood sticking out from the front of it to bring it right underneath my face. That's terrible news, Frank. Hey, Frank, wait. We'll sing her a song, Frank. What song does she like to hear, Frank? It's gotta be one that I know, though. Great, Jeff. I'll show you, or I'll send you a picture of my setup, Jeff. Carpenters, what song? I'm trying to think if I know any Carpenter songs. I know the name of the group. I can't remember which songs are theirs. Yep. Don't know that one. I don't know Top of the World either. I don't know enough Carpenter's music. Oh no! Suddenly appear every time you are near. That's all I know of that song. Just like me, they long to be close to you. Thanks, wife. I don't know, Daniel. I'm not sure if I can get away with it yet. I'll have to check with the wife.
Drop kick me, Jesus, through the goalpost of life.
I don't know that one. Valentine's Serenade, yeah. Woohoo! That way everybody's happy. What's up, Earl? Yeah, this is Easy Wood Tools, medium size diamond detailer.
No problem, Jeff.
What else does she like, Frank? Know that I know a single Ramones song. All right, Becky, I'm gonna make this one kind of nice and slim, so you can carry it around and use it a lot. Cause it's gonna look real good. Not that one, Rick. Baby shark, doo 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 doo. Baby shark, doo 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 doo. Baby shark, doo 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 doo. Baby shark. I wanna be sedated. I don't know any of that song. I like that song a lot, but I don't know any of how it goes though. No, Brett. The negative rake is cool, except for the part where you can't sharpen it. And no thank you to not being able to sharpen it. Because I can sharpen these all I want, and it's nice. There's enough wheels on the bus going round and round in my house all the time. This is my escape from that. Sir. Killing me, Smalls. I was right. I thought you guys were supposed to want the best for me, not the worst. I come out of the hospital with more than one kid, me and all of y'all are gonna have a serious sit down. Did start it, but we all know that Neil started it because he could only make twins. And he's sad because that's his only strong suit. Neil's a twins making man. We'd call him two a day. Yeah. I guess that's just how y'all roll in Canada. I hear ya. Well, this is gonna look really, really cool. What's Tupac? Is that Tupac's white cousin? That's fantastic, Cliff. Tupac's way better. That's fantastic. Oh my goodness. Oh, that's why he always says pop, pop. Cause that's how. Yeah. Every time anything good happens for Neil, he says pop, pop. Absolutely not, Shirley. I just want to do hood rat stuff with my friends. Dang, this color is gonna be exceptional. Hooray! Thank you.
Oh, wow. Okay. This is going to be amazing looking. Dang. Sweet, sweet, sweet. Yeah, Becky, this blank was a great choice. Really, really good choice. Well decided upon. All right, Bean.
See you later, boss.
This thing's gonna be sick, dude. Port of entry. Yeah. Appreciate it, Johnny.
wrong direction. Yeah, don't forget how freaking hard Cholla is. It'll take out your regular people tools pretty quick. It ain't playing no games. Thank you.
Oh boy. That thing is a killer, y'all. Oh man. What a beautiful piece. Wow, wow, wow. Neil, you got the placement spot on, buddy. This is freaking amazing looking. Can't beat this with a stick. I'm trying. Yeah, buddy. Lovely thing. Yeehaw. Hey, Gene, what's up, buddy? How you doing, man? Part is really tedious, y'all. We want to get it right, though. Ain't playing no games with these things today. No games. Okay. So that's looking pretty much amazing. It's about to look much more better.
Woo!
It's gonna look especially better too. Because today, unlike last time, hey Wally, what's up, buddy? I actually have freaking shop rags to put on the CA with. Hooray! Now, what I'm interested in is my go-to rags have had a complete change of formula. They're different material, it looks like. Different, it's got texture in the fabric that I didn't have before, and all kinds of stuff. Look at this crazy stuff. It's got all kinds of shapes. But we'll see. Maybe it'll be nice enough. Giving it one box of chance. This is Cholla Hybrid, Wally. Yeah, no problem. Gonna be gorgeous. Hooray! It looks nice, man. I know it's kind of hard to see over there. Hang on. Try that on for size. Appreciate it, Wally. That's great, man. Yeah, that's why I do this. So everybody can watch and learn and then tell me some stuff if you got it. What's up, Ethan? Welcome back, buddy. Yeah, buddy. I do the cooking in the family. The wife is not a good cook. Well, she is learning to be a good cook, but she didn't have any cooking skills before she got a hold of me. So we've been learning her as she goes. So yes, I am the cook and I am in the house. I guess right now the cook is in the shop. Man, this color is sweet! Awesome, Wally. It's great news, buddy.
What's up, Troy?
Recipe.
Absolutely not.
The type on medium. No problem, buddy. What's up, Evan? How you doing, Tony? All right. Appreciate it, Elvin. Let's get ready and shine this thing up, shall we? Look good, feel good. Yes, sir, it's pop-pop time. Up in here.
Alright, let me get some clean water. I'm gonna chuck some sandpaper real quick and get me some new zone paper. Just a minute, team. get me out a new set of zone paper squares. Just a sec. Arizona. Let's get cracking on this thing, shall we?
Get cracking.
All right.
No, Tony. I only tighten up my tailstock tight enough for, I just tighten it up until it starts to turn the tailstock. And I stop. That's pretty much it. But no, no bending issues. There's very commonly some alignment issues you gotta tweak a little bit to make sure it's dead on center, but no, I don't have any problems bending the mandrel at all, no. Yeah, no problem. Yeah, I don't know why everybody bends these things. I don't know what they think they're working with. It's not like it's gonna jump off the thing with you. Gotta do a little finesse work, you know. Not so much ground and pound. Wally, I'm running at 2670 the whole time, buddy. The boys are up. Oh, it's game over now. See you tomorrow, Neil. Will do, buddy. You know it. No problem, Molly.
What's up, Brian? Welcome back, buddy. How you doing, man? Three micron it is. I hear you, ma'am. Ted Jenkins in the house. What's up, Seth? And the mother load. Single micron. Woo! No, while these things are so light grade, and also there's a thin coating of CA over top of the steel bushings because I let my CA wrap over them. So I'm really technically just kind of rubbing off that extra little bit of CA. Sweet, Seth. That's awesome, buddy. I want to see that when it's done. Point 0.4 to 0.6. I want to see some of that, man. I'm going to need you to send me a piece. No, not generally, Wally. Every 30 or 40 pins, maybe I'll have one to do it. But generally speaking, no. Boom. That will do. Thanks very much, Shiny News on a Paper. Killer. Fiber optic cores prior to splicing. That's baller. There you go. One side. Two side. Zona paper, Wally. Appreciate it, Seth. All right, now we're heading in the right direction. Now let's make it shiny, shall we? All right. The white one was 1 micron, which is equivalent to between 13,000 and 14,000 grit, depending on who you ask. Does that result in me getting money, Everett?
Never heard of this. I like it. What is it?
I think maybe you're right, Matthew. So this is what you get when you pull them out of your steel bushings, and you just knock that excess off and you're good to roll.
Oops, whacked myself in the head with you guys.
Always make sure you're sanding towards the inside of the barrel when you do this. You don't want that CA to start walking back up the side again. Once you've already got it in a good place. One side. I'd say more like 75 degrees. Like that. Alrighty. Got those end pieces knocked off. Let's these are the buddies. Bring y'all back around here real quick.
Let's buff it out.
No, I don't put wax on mine. They stay pretty well slippery just from being nice and smooth. So no, I don't spend the time to put the wax on there. No issues much ever. So, I mean, I think the wax will help if you're worried about it sticking, but I don't have any sticking to it issues, so I don't spend the energy to try to wax them. I've done it once or twice on something where I literally had to like dump CA on it for some reason because it was like cracked and I had to fill in a bunch of cracks for a pin of Neil's that he sent me to repair that was broken. That was the only time I ever used wax on my bushings. Which worked. I mean, it worked fine, but I don't find it to be necessary. Alrighty, second side. Yeah, no problem, Mon. Alrighty, that's just about done now. Let's take a little look-see, shall we? Perfect timing, Neil. That's pretty luscious. So there you go. That's our handy dandy CA finish. If you do your CA finishes like that, they'll look like this. Boom. All right. Grab this kit here. Just a second, I'm gonna get you guys and bring you all along with us.
Close your eyes, Becky. We're going for a ride.
Hold on, lady. We're going for a ride.
There we go. Okay.
Alright, sorry, who's saying what now?
Do you see any gold in it?
Gold in it? Yeah, I can see the gold flake in it, man, yeah, for sure. Whew! This finish is on point. I'm proud of this finish. This turned out really good. I mean, smooth, smooth. Hooray! Don't forget to breathe, Becky. It's important. This finish is good even for me. I'm excited about this one. On a main highway, all right. Welcome back to the main. Yeah, it's dead smooth. I'm excited about it. Very, very good. Very good. This kit has so many dang baggies with it. Because each piece has multiple pieces. Trout and shine, yeah, buddy. Buff Club, woo!
Alright, we're almost all out of the baggies here.
Sorry, I'm slow.
But if you lose one of these rings, they're hard to go find. So you gotta be very gentle with the opening process and all this crap. Because there are two rings on each one of these things. And they will run away from you. Which will leave you very sad.
Which will leave you very sad.
Yes,
Tony?
Yep. It is indeed a Kojent. It's a Woodcraft kit, rollerball and fountain. This one's a rollerball. Called the Kojent, K-O-J-E-N-T. It's about 17 to 18 bucks, depending on which one you get, which finish, and if it's rollerball or fountain. But they're pretty cheap compared to like the Junior Series kits. That's why I like them.
And they work on the exact same bushings, the same barrels, same size pin. Finish size is exactly the same. So I really like this kit because it's just like the Junior Series, but cheaper. But with the same kind of quality materials and quality of a look of a finished product. So I'm on Team Kojent. Ooh, this is going to look classy. Classy, classy. Nicely classy. Hey. Let's see. Which is about the same, and it's rollerball as well. Yeah, the La Veche is the same. I can't remember if it uses the same barrels or not. I know it's definitely different bushing sizes. Different bits too? Alright, yeah. Smaller, I think. If I'm not mistaken. And I've been mistaken before. Sorry about that, I'm back. I was back. Yep, the La Veche is really nice. I really like that kit a lot. For me, the La Veche kit is harder to get the exact shape that I want. The La Veche has to be a lot straighter than my pins usually are to look right. I've tried to make a couple of them with some figure, some shape to them, and they never look good. So that kit is one that works well with a straight across bushing to bushing type design in the shape of the pin. Sweet! Celia, what's up, buddy? How are you? Oh, sorry, yeah. ADD.
Alright, one second. Let me
sit this thing down and I'll take the camera off here real quick and we'll take a look-see. And we are done.
Oh, oh, oh. Just a sec, team. Sit this thing down real quick. Here on the head of the outfit.
Here we go. So here is the Canoe Lake. Yeah, this thing's pretty special. Give me 1 second. Let me let you stare at the ground for just a moment. Hang on a second. Appreciate it, Tony. Yeah, this thing looks very high class. And the finish is, I mean, it is good. That's probably one of my better finishes. I'm excited about that finish. Appreciate it, Neil. Yeah, I like this one. I like it a lot. You're very welcome, Becky. Yeehaw! Alright, let's see. 1 sec. Let me, we'll take a look at them separate. Sorry about that. So here we have, oops, the two sections. Alrighty. Appreciate y'all. Y'all have a lovely evening. We'll do it again soon. Thanks a lot, guys. How close you want to be, Neil? It's cactus, Joe. Yeah, the color's just hard to see. It doesn't want to focus on it because there's such contrast, but it's there. The color is loud. It'll be easier to see in the pictures, but the video didn't want to focus in on it real good. But yeah, the color is there for sure. So is the flake. Yeehaw! All right. Thanks a lot, y'all.